How did you get into this?
You actually know the part of the story.
I know the story, but they don't know the story.
I'll give a quick recap. So 2.5 years ago, I moved to LA. I used to flip homes in Texas. Prior to that, I was a student at Texas A&M. I was an athlete back then. So I graduated there, got into flipping, kind of like investing in real estate around 2015, 2016 heavily. Flipped about 30, 40 homes back in Texas. And after that, I was like, you have money, you know, you always wanted to move to LA. Why don't you just take the leap of faith and just move there? And initially, I wasn't sure what I wanted to do in LA. I was like, maybe I develop properties. Maybe I learned the real estate market a little bit. So 2.5 years ago, I moved to LA, got my real estate license and got into the business. And the way I grew the business was really simple. I actually took your course, real estate course.
It's awesome. And both courses, by the way.
Both courses.
Real estate and YouTube.
I mean,
link down below in the description.
Actually, now that I think, just speaking out loud, you had a huge influence on how I kind of built my business in general. And 3 months in, going to Brokers Open, seeing the homes, and you know, me coming from a contracting background, I was like, why nobody's talking about these homes? And we have Mikey right around the corner. I called Mikey probably 2 to 3 months being into real estate agent. I was like, Mikey, I'm not making any money. I don't know much, you know, I don't know many people here, but these Brokers Opens are amazing. Why don't you move to LA? You can sleep on my couch. And on like the side, we'll start shooting some videos. And I watched your YouTube Academy. I was like, seems simple enough. And we just started shooting homes and here we are.
Explain that more. You didn't just start shooting homes and then we're here.
Fair enough.
Then you woke up one morning, a million subscribers.
Yeah, okay, fair enough.
So how did this happen?
We started shooting and it sucked at the beginning. I mean, it was like we were getting like 100 to 200 views. We were basically touring Brokers Open. And
I remember, wait, was this with your GoPro or what? You were touring with a GoPro. I remember watching your early videos when you first reached out, and we'll talk about that in a second because that's a crazy story.
Yeah.
Watching these videos, and it's just a GoPro, just kind of walking around these like $5 to $10 million houses in Beverly Hills or Bel Air. That's it. Really no commentary. You see people like getting out of your way as you're walking around. The houses are packed.
You know why we were using GoPro? Number one, obviously it was easy to use. Number two, we were so small. Nobody knew us. We were kind of embarrassed almost what we were doing. We were like, let's just use a GoPro. Let's just stay low key.
Yeah.
And me and Mikey were just touring these homes, getting sound bites. I was talking about details here and there. And I think maybe I could be wrong on this. We made like 12 to 15 videos and we were at like 300 subscribers. Like it was a grind, like it wasn't moving. We weren't really getting any progress. And I remember at that time we watched your academy probably twice at that point. I was like, we gotta find a way to meet Graham. Now I haven't told you this, but I've emailed you before moving to LA. I've emailed you probably 2 to 3 weeks after moving to LA. And I've never heard back, which now don't blame you. The amount of emails and DMs we get.
Hundreds per day.
It's impossible.
Mind-boggling. It's impossible to we'll sort through all the titles, but even like the we miss emails so much. So we got to work on that.
Now, like no hard feelings. Yeah. Like I totally get it. And then I saw this listing that hit the market, and you were either a co-listing agent or you were a listing agent on it. I told Mikey about it. I was like, Mikey, Graham listed a property, because at the time it was hard to find you. You weren't really fully into real estate. This was like probably little less than 2 years ago. And then,
this is just, by the way, as I was phasing out, I was focusing more time on YouTube, and a client called me from YouTube, believe it or not, saw my YouTube video and said, I forget how she reached out. I think she found one of my other email addresses, reached out to me saying that she had a $5.5 million home in West Hollywood.
Okay.
And I was scaling back, but this was like right up the street from my office. I spoke with Jason to make
sure.
Good
listing.
Yeah, it was a great listing. Right up the street from the office, $5.5 million, view of the entire city. And Jason said, listen, don't worry about it. If you're not able to make a showing, I'll make the showing. So we were able to make it work, but that's how I got the listing, is from YouTube.
There you go. Yeah. That's amazing.
Yeah.
And I remember seeing the listing. I was like, Mikey, Graham's listing a property. And then I saw the Brokers Open. I was like, Graham is going to be there. Mikey was like, you know, we reached out to him. He never got back. I don't know. Maybe we shouldn't like push this any more further. I was like, I don't want to hesitate this. Let's just go. So we literally came to that open house just to see you. And I remember really well, because after meeting you, Mikey was like, you came in really hot. Like, you were like, hey guys, welcome to my listing. I was like, we're not here for your listing. We just came to meet you. Like, I almost came off too bold, but that was the time we met you and you gave us like some really good advice. I remember so well.
I think I was editing, by the way, in that open house. I had my computer open because it was a slow open house.
Yeah.
Because what happens in Los Angeles is that when you list a house like that, the first weekend is packed. All the agents and people go and see the brand new listing. After the first week, it really settles down. So you really had that beginning, that momentum. I think you came in like the second or third week, I think.
Possible.
On a Sunday. It was a slow Sunday. I was editing.
Yeah,
I
possible.
You guys walking in. Yeah.
And then, like, I remember one of the first things, I'm sure Mikey remembers it too. We were doing like vlog number 11, 12. You're like, no one cares. No one cares about the number. He's title these videos. I was like, wait, what? Like, no one cares? Like, what do you mean? Like, I couldn't even comprehend what that meant at the time. We were so, like, I guess, not educated enough about YouTube and platform. But that's how we kind of met you for the first time. Yeah.